Hello everyone, in this session we'll be learning about the femoral triangle as well as adductor canal from the anatomy decoded notes. Okay, both these topics are very important as far as theory exams are concerned. Okay, adductor canal is usually asked as a short note, and femoral triangle you can ask as a short note as well as a long answer question. Okay, so make sure you study both these topics very well, and we can also ask these topics in practical exams. Okay. And this is the QR code which you can scan and get access to all our notes. Okay, so let's begin with the topic. Yes, here as you can see, the femoral triangle concised in one page with all the important key headings, explanation and the diagram. Okay, we'll be learning headings one by one. Okay, the first heading is location. Where is the femoral triangle located? It is a triangular hollow which is located in the anteromedial aspect of the upper one-third of the thigh. Okay. Supposing this is the right-sided thigh region, in the region of the upper one-third, there is a triangular area which is there. Okay. So that's the location of femoral triangle. And then what are the boundaries? Boundaries are divided in different headings. Medial boundary is formed by a muscle called as adductor longus muscle. And specifically, there is the medial border of adductor longus. Okay, and lateral boundary is formed by the medial border of sartorius muscle. Okay, this muscle is sartorius. Okay, then roof is formed by skin, superficial fascia containing the superficial branches of the femoral artery and its accompanying veins, as well as the great saphenous vein and the superficial inguinal lymph nodes. Okay, so roof. In general, you can remember skin, superficial fascia and deep fascia, but in superficial fascia, there would be some structures that are specific to a particular region. Okay, so in the femoral triangle, these are the structures which are there. Okay, then there is the apex of the femoral triangle. It is the meeting point of adductor longus and sartorius. Okay, so in this region, the adductor longus and sartorius are meeting. Okay, that's the apex. And base is formed by the inguinal ligament. Okay, opposite the apex is the base. Okay, so here as we can see, this is the pubic tubercle and this is the anterior superior iliac spine. Stretching between these two points is the inguinal ligament that forms the base. Okay, then floor of femoral triangle, from medial to lateral, it is remembered by a mnemonic APPI. Okay, A for adductor longus, then P for pectineus, then P is for sos major, specifically the tendon of sos major, and I is for iliacus. Okay, so these are four structures from medial to lateral which are forming the floor. Okay, and then contents of the femoral triangle, it is remembered by a mnemonic van, van, from medial to lateral. Okay, V stands for the femoral vein. Okay, V is for the vein which is femoral vein. So when we say vein, it is along with the tributaries. Okay, then A is for artery, femoral artery and its branches. N is for nerve, the femoral nerve and its branches. Okay, and this femoral vein and femoral artery, they are covered in a sheath that is referred to as femoral sheath. Okay, so that femoral sheath you can see here. Okay, this one is the femoral sheath in which the femoral vein and the artery is covered. Okay, apart from this, there are deep inguinal lymph nodes, lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh, the femoral branch of the genitofemoral nerve, and some fibrofatty tissue. Okay, so all these contents are shown in this diagram. Okay, now let's learn a little bit details about this femoral sheath, femoral canal, and what is the femoral ring. Okay, the femoral sheath that we saw, which is covering the femoral vein and artery, it has got three compartments. Okay, the lateral compartment is the one which is having the artery as well as the genitofemoral nerve. Intermediate compartment is having a vein, that's the femoral vein, and the medial compartment is known as the femoral canal. Okay, so this vertical space here, medially, that's the femoral canal. Okay, and this femoral canal has got clinical significance, so it is described in further details. Okay, the upper end of the femoral canal, which opens into the abdominal cavity, is referred to as femoral ring. Okay, so canal is a vertically long structure. Its upper end is referred to as femoral ring, which has got certain boundaries. Anteriorly, it is bounded by inguinal ligament. Medially, there is a ligament called as lacunar ligament. Posteriorly is the pectin pubis. Pectin pubis, it's a part of the hip bone. Okay, Then laterally is femoral vein, as we can see here. Okay, so all these are the boundaries of the femoral ring. Now let's come to the applied anatomy of the femoral triangle. Okay, the first applied anatomy mentioned is femoral hernia. Okay, it is protrusion of the abdominal contents, usually a part of intestine, through the femoral canal. Okay, so that's why femoral canal we have learned here. Okay, so from the femoral canal, the intestinal contents can come inside the thigh. Okay, the femoral hernia will present a swelling which is inferolateral to the pubic tubercle. Okay, there is a bony part that's referred to as the pubic tubercle. It is inferior as well as lateral. Okay, a swelling inferolateral to pubic tubercle is femoral hernia. Then what is the course of the femoral hernia? It comes downwards, then it moves forwards, and then it moves upwards. Okay, so when it goes downwards, it is passing through the femoral canal. When it goes forwards, it is passing through the opening called as saphenous opening. This is an opening in the deep fascia of the thigh. Okay, and finally it goes upwards in the superficial fascia of the thigh. Okay, that's the course of the femoral hernia. Then if the femoral hernia is strangulated, okay, strangulated means it can get narrowed and it can cause pain, for which surgical reduction may be required. Okay, so for surgically reducing the hernia, the lacunar ligament is cut. Okay, lacunar ligament, as we can see, it forms the medial boundary. Okay, so this is cut to enlarge the femoral ring. Okay, so if we see the other boundaries, laterally there is femoral vein which we cannot cut, posteriorly there is pectin pubis, bone we cannot cut. Okay, and anteriorly is the main inguinal ligament, that also we cannot cut. Okay, only the lacunar ligament can be cut to relieve the femoral hernia. Okay, then mid inguinal point, what is it? It is a point which is the midpoint of pubic symphysis and anterior superior iliac spine. Okay, if we see this region, this part is the pubic symphysis, this is the anterior superior iliac spine. Okay, midpoint of this, it's coming here. Okay, so it is the location of femoral artery. Okay, femoral artery is located at the level of mid inguinal point. Okay, so to identify this artery, this mid inguinal point is important for doing some procedures like angiography. A cannula can be inserted through the femoral artery to inject the dye. Okay, then there is a point called as midpoint of inguinal ligament. Okay, so if you see this point, that's the pubic tubercle, and again this is anterior superior iliac spine. If you see midpoint of this, it is coming slightly lateral to the femoral artery. Okay, that point is for the location of femoral nerve, if in case nerve block has to be given. Okay, and in relations also we know the nerve lies lateral to the artery. Okay, then inguinal lymphadenopathy. Inguinal lymph nodes can get swelled up due to infection of the lower limb, and it should be differentiated from ectopic testis or femoral hernia or sauce abscess, that can also cause swelling in this region. Okay, so this was about the femoral triangle, all the important points with the boundaries, contents, and the applied anatomy we have covered with the help of these notes. Okay, make sure you all access these notes from the link which is given in the description box below. Let's move on to the next topic now. Okay, so now let's cover the adductor canal topic. Okay, adductor canal, it is also referred to as subsartorial canal. It is also referred to as Hunter's canal. Okay, why it is called so? Because subsartorial means it is present beneath the sartorius. Okay, so to understand the location of adductor canal, look at this region. Okay, here we can see this is the sartorius muscle arising from anterior superior iliac spine, going towards the upper medial aspect of the tibia. Look at the middle part of the sartorius. Okay, it is actually the middle one third of the thigh. Deep to it, there is a tunnel like space that is referred to as adductor canal. Okay, so deep to sartorius it is there, that's why it is called as subsartorial canal. And Hunter's canal, because scientist Dr. John Hunter first described it. Okay, that's why it is called as Hunter's canal also. Okay, so location, as we have seen, it is a intermuscular tunnel on the middle one third of the thigh. Okay, it extends from apex of femoral triangle to the opening in the adductor magnus, which is called as hiatus magnus. Okay, this part is the apex of femoral triangle, And in adductor magnus, there is an opening called as hiatus magnus, through which the femoral vessels, they continue as the popliteal vessels. Okay, so till that point, this adductor canal is extending. Then boundaries of adductor canal. So to understand the boundaries, we have to understand a cross section at the adductor canal. Okay, so let's look at this cross section. So you can imagine this part, right thigh, which is cut, and we are viewing from the inferior aspect. Okay, right thigh cut and viewed from the inferior aspect. A schematic diagram is drawn here. Okay, orientation marks are given here. First orient yourself towards the image, then only you'll be able to understand the boundaries. The anterolateral wall is formed by vastus medialis. Okay, so this muscle that we can see, that is anterior to the adductor canal as well as it is lateral to the adductor canal. Okay, that's why it is referred to as anterolateral boundary. Okay, here many a time student gets confused. The name of the muscle is vastus medialis, how it is coming in the lateral boundary. Okay, because anatomically it is lateral to the adductor canal. Okay, so that's the anterolateral boundary, vastus medialis. Then posterior boundary is formed by adductor longus. So here we can see the adductor longus muscle, which is labeled. Okay, and medial boundary is formed by a fibrous membrane which stretches along the anterolateral and the posterior boundaries. So that green colored membrane that we can see here, that is forming the medial wall, and it is overlapped by the sartorius muscle. Okay, and in between them there are some nerves called as subsartorial plexus of nerves. Okay, all these are coming in the medial boundary. And contents of adductor canal, the femoral artery, femoral vein, which was there in the femoral triangle, they are continuing here. And this saphenous nerve, it's one of the branch of the femoral nerve. Okay, from the posterior division of the femoral nerve, a cutaneous nerve comes, that is the saphenous nerve. And there is a nerve to vastus medialis. Okay, vastus medialis is a muscle. Nerve to vastus medialis is seen in adductor canal. Then there are branches of the obturator nerve. Then descending genicular artery, it is a branch of the femoral artery. Okay, you can see the femoral artery, it will give a branch called as descending genicular artery that goes towards the knee joint. Okay, so this was about the contents. So in applied anatomy, what is there? It is written a popliteal artery aneurysm. Okay, behind the knee there is a fossa that's referred to as popliteal fossa. The wall of the artery can get thinned out and it can bulge. That condition is referred to as popliteal artery aneurysm. Okay, if there is an aneurysm, usually the artery has to be ligated. But if we try to ligate in popliteal fossa, there is a chance that the artery could rupture. Okay, so for that, the femoral artery is ligated in the adductor canal. Okay, because femoral artery continues as the popliteal artery. Okay, in this image, just see how the femoral artery is continuing as the popliteal artery. Okay, so if there is an aneurysm of the popliteal artery, if we tie the femoral artery, then this aneurysm size will decrease and the surgical procedure can be done to restore the normal function. Okay, so that is one important applied anatomy for the adductor canal. Okay, this procedure was first performed by Dr. John Hunter. Okay, so this was about the femoral triangle as well as the adductor canal. Okay, make sure you access these notes from the link in the description box below. Okay, thank you.